हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर आशीष अग्रावत। वेलकम टू माय चैनल लाइव बायोकेमिस्ट्री। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द विटामिन सी। सो विटामिन सी वी विल कवर इन दिस वीडियो अबाउट द सोर्सेस ऑफ विटामिन सी, फंक्शंस, बायोकेमिकल फंक्शंस ऑफ विटामिन सी एंड डेफिशिएंसी मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ विटामिन सी। इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। इट इज आस्क्ड इन ऑल टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम ऑल्सो एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। ओके, so stay tuned and watch this video till the end. It will be very useful to you, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get the notification for the future video. So stay tuned, and you can see in the background that is a orange. So you can see this vitamin C. Orange is a good source of vitamin C. Okay, so now I'm going to share the screen. So vitamin C, okay, so we will cover about the chemistry, biosynthesis and metabolism, dietary source and requirement, biochemical function, deficiency manifestation, therapeutic use and toxicity, right? So you can see here many sailors or seamen were dying because of the vitamin C deficiency, okay, because of the infections like that. So a Royal Navy surgeon, James Lynn, who gave citrus fruit to all the sailors or Navy men or seamen, and he found that all the sailors were cured, okay, by giving the citrus fruit and juice. We give the orange, give the lemon, and many sailors were cured. So this is why the vitamin C is important. So as we know, it is a water-soluble vitamin. Okay, its structure is resembling to the carbohydrates because of its N-dual group, and it has a strong reducing property. Okay, it is destroyed by the heat and alkali, and only it is also called as ascorbic acid. Vitamin C, other name is ascorbic acid or ascorbate. Okay, only L form, L ascorbic acid and D hydroascorbic acid have anti-scorbutic activity. Okay, while D form does not have this activity. So you can see this is a reduced form. This is called as a L ascorbic acid. And when two hydrogens are removed, so that oxidation occurs. So by oxidation, it is converted to D hydroascorbic acid. So D hydroascorbic acid is a oxidized form, and ascorbic acid is in reduced form. So this is how vitamin C will help in the oxidation and reduction reaction. Okay. Most animal and plants can synthesize the ascorbic acid from glucose. We human, higher primates cannot synthesize because of the lack of the enzyme ulonolactone oxidase. Okay, ulonolactone oxidase. Remember the name of this enzyme. It is frequently asked in many competitive exams. Ulonolactone oxidase. This enzyme is lacking in our human and many primates, higher primates. So we cannot synthesize vitamin C in our body. So it has to be supplied in the diet in the form of orange, lemon, citrus fruits, etc. Okay. So we will see also here. The UDP glucose is converted to glucuronic acid and ultimately L-gulonic acid. This L-gulonic acid is converted to L-gulonolactone, and L-gulonolactone is converted to 2-keto-L-gulonolactone. This requires a gulonolactone oxidase enzyme, and ultimately it is gulonolactone is converted to ascorbic acid. So this is possible in lower animals. In human, we cannot synthesize because the lack of this enzyme. So ultimately it is channeled to the pentose phosphate pathway. I will make separate video about the glucuronic acid pathway. Okay, so just as present, remember this gulonolactone, okay, oxidase that will mediate convert L-gulonolactone to 2-keto-L-gulonolactone, which can be ultimately converted to vitamin C. This enzyme is absent in human. So we cannot synthesize vitamin C in our body, while lower animals can synthesize it. So the deficiency manifestation charts are more. Okay. So what are the sources? So citrus fruits and juice, like orange, okay, lemon, raspberry, blueberry, grapefruit, they are good source. Okay, also it is present in papaya, pineapple, mango also. And in vegetables also, cauliflower, tomato, they are the potato, they are good source of vitamin C. In amla, okay, we get the, out of 100 gram, we get 700 milligram. It is the richest source of vitamin C. And daily requirement is 75 milligram per day. Okay. So the daily requirement of vitamin C is 75. Rich source are orange, lemon, okay, other fruits like raspberry, grapes, okay, and amla is a very good source of vitamin C. Okay. Now it is absorbed in our GI tract, okay, with the sodium dependent active transport or simple diffusion at higher concentration, at low concentration with the help of active transport. Most of 80 to 90% is absorbed, okay, dietary vitamin C, and from intestine to blood it is diffused by the facilitated diffusion. Just to know the points, it is actually uptake by the transporters, sodium dependent transporters. It is present in pituitary, adrenal gland, corpus luteum, thymus, etc. And retina has a very good source. Normal level in plasma is 0.7 to 1.5 milligram. Okay, in WBC it is present in 25 milligram. And from maternal blood it can cross the placenta. Okay, vitamin C. Is it excreted in the urine and it gives a false positive Benedict test. The level is increased in healing wounds. And it is decreased in patients with contraceptive pills and chronic alcoholism. So we can see ascorbic acid, which is in reduced form, it is oxidized to dehydroascorbic acid. Then with the help of H2O, it is converted to ketogulonic acid. And then it is oxidized to irreversible form, that is called oxalic acid. That is how vitamin C is related to oxalic acid. Now we will see functions of vitamin C. So far we have seen daily requirement is 75 milligram per day. Sources are orange, lemon, amla, okay, all the citrus fruits and vegetables. They are good source of vitamin C, right? And it has a good L-form ascorbic acid. L-form of ascorbic acid. It is oxidized to dehydroascorbic acid, which is an oxidized form. Ascorbic acid is a reduced form, right? So there is interconversion between these two forms. And in human, guanylate oxidase enzyme is deficient. So we cannot synthesize vitamin C in our body. So biochemical function, it mediates the oxidation reduction reaction. We have already seen ascorbic acid is converted to dehydroascorbic acid. Then it is very important for the collagen synthesis. Okay. For conversion of lysine and proline, they are converted to hydroxylysine and hydroxyproline. So they will provide by hydroxylation, there is an interchain hydrogen bond formation occur and they will provide stability to the collagen, right? So they are also important for the functional activity of the fibroblasts, osteoblasts, connective tissue, osteoid tissue, dentin, like that. You can see proline is converted to hydroxyproline. Lysine is converted to hydroxylysine with the help of vitamin C, right? Enzyme is hydroxylase enzyme. So far we have seen its role in the oxidation reduction reaction, its role in the collagen formation by converting lysine and proline into the post-translational modification hydroxyproline and hydroxylysine. Now it can act as a cofactor for hydroxylation of tryptophan to 5-hydroxytryptophan, which is, so tryptophan we have seen in the metabolism of tryptophan. Okay, you can watch my video regarding the tryptophan metabolism, link is given just above. So tryptophan is converted to 5-hydroxytryptophan. Okay, so hydroxylase enzyme here, it requires the vitamin C. And what about the 5-hydroxytryptophan is converted to 5-hydroxytryptamine, which is called as a serotonin. Here there is a vitamin B6 dependent decarboxylation occur. Okay, so this is serotonin. So for the formation of serotonin, this tryptophan vitamin C is very important. Then in the tyrosine metabolism, so we know that phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine, and tyrosine is converted to PHPP by transaminase enzyme, and PHPP is converted to homogentisate. Now this conversion of para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogentisate, it requires PHPP hydroxylase enzyme, and here we require the vitamin C. You can watch my video regarding this tyrosine metabolism, phenylalanine and tyrosine metabolism, link is given just above. So for the tryptophan metabolism, for the tyrosine metabolism, it is very important. Then formation of tetrahydrofolic acid. As we know, folic acid is converted to dihydrofolic acid. Then it is converted to tetrahydrofolic acid, which is the active form of folic acid. And this folic acid, tetrahydrofolic acid, is a donor acceptor of the one carbon metabolism. So it can take the one carbon substance like formyl, okay, methionyl, methylene, methyl, and they can donate to the substance that requires. You can also watch my video regarding the one carbon metabolism. Right, so formation of tetrahydrofolic acid, the enzyme is folic acid reductase. So here vitamin C is the very important. Right, so far we have seen what is the function. One is the oxidation, reduction, reaction. Second, very important, is for the collagen synthesis, most important, because many efficiency manifestations are regarding to this function. So they will convert lysine and proline to the hydroxyproline and hydroxylysine, and that will help in the stability, interchain hydrogen formation. That's why for the synthesis of collagen, this is vitamin C is very important. Third is, it is present in the fibroblast, connective tissue, dentine, etc. Then fourth is in the tryptophan metabolism. So tryptophan to 5-hydroxytryptophan, the hydroxylase enzyme, it acts as a cofactor. Then fifth is in the tyrosine metabolism, where para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate is converted to homogentisate. Okay. Six in the formation of folic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid by folic acid dihydrofolate reductase enzyme requires the vitamin C. Okay. Then regarding the how it has role, if there is a vitamin C deficiency, it leads to anemia. Why? Because it will convert, because it has a strong reducing property, it can help in conversion of ferric form to the ferrous form, right? Then formation of dopamine to norepinephrine. So we have seen that tyrosine can be converted to, by the hydroxylase enzyme, it is converted to dopa. Dopa is decarboxylated to dopamine. Okay, and this conversion of dopamine to norepinephrine, here the enzyme is dopamine hydroxylase enzyme, and here it requires the vitamin C. So noradrenaline, ultimately it is the transmethylation reaction, it is converted to epinephrine. So these are the neurotransmitters. So it is very important, and they are called as a catecholamine. Okay, so fight and flight reaction, they are important. So formation of catecholamines also required the vitamin C. Then formation of carnitine. As we know, carnitine is made up of lysine and methionine, and which play important role in the transport of fatty acid in the mitochondrial membrane, which is a key step in fatty acid oxidation. So without carnitine, fatty acid will not be oxidized, so ATP will not be formed. So very important function of vitamin C in formation of carnitine. Also, it has a role in oxidation of fatty acid. Okay, so alpha oxidation of long chain fatty acid is converted to alpha hydroxy fatty acid. Then act on certain enzyme, arginase and pepen, they are activated with the help of vitamin C, while urease and beta amylase, they are inhibited. Then we have one function seen, that ferric form is converted to ferrous form, and methemoglobin is converted to hemoglobin. Right. Also in the bile acid synthesis, cholesterol is converted to bile acid. Okay, so by the 7-alpha hydroxylase enzyme, and this bile acid bind with the glycine and taurine, and ultimately form the bile salts, which are very important in the digestion of the lipids. Okay, whatever oily food we take, for the digestion, bile salts are required, which are synthesized with the help of vitamin C.
Then phagocytic action of WBC and formation of antibody also require vitamin C. It acts as an antioxidant. It will decrease the DNA oxidation, arrest the protein damage, decrease the lipid peroxidation, prevent the atherosclerosis, decrease production of extracellular oxidants from the neutrophil. So this is how it has the role as an antioxidant. It decreases the risk of the cataract. For the mineralization also, it is very important. And it is a component of the drug metabolizing enzyme system. Okay, particularly the oxidase system. So this all are the function of vitamin C. So biochemical function. Biochemical functions. So oxidation, reduction, reaction, right? Second in the collagen formation, very important function. Okay. Then in the fibroblast, connective tissue, it is very important. Then for the tryptophan metabolism, for the tyrosine metabolism, right? For the bile acid synthesis. For tetrahydrofolic acid formation, for the folate reductase enzyme, it is very important. Right? Formation of catecholamine, it is very important. Then conversion of methemoglobin to hemoglobin, conversion of ferric ion to ferrous ion, it has role as a antioxidant, right? So these are all function of vitamin C, main function. It is also important in carnitine, right? Metabolism of and alpha oxidation to decrease the cataract. So all are the function of vitamin C. Okay, you can see here. So formation of arginase pepin, it is also required, right? Phagocytic action. So all are the function of vitamin C, right? So if any person who does not take vitamin, and it is not produced in our human. Okay, remember, uronolactone oxidase enzyme is deficient in human. So if a person don't take citrus fruits in the diet, then the person is suffered from the vitamin C deficiency. Okay, also we have seen that many person are now, we are asked to take vitamin C. Limsi tablet is there, 500 milligram. In the area of pandemic, we should take this vitamin C, which has a very important antioxidant role. It is a phagocytic action. So you can take vitamin C in your diet in this pandemic of coronavirus. So it is very important to boost your immune system. There is a tablet called Limsi, which is chewable, brand name, 500 milligram per day you can take, right? So deficiency, it will lead to the scurvy. So what is scurvy? There is type like infantile scurvy. It is called as a Barlow's disease. It takes place in infant between 6 to 12 months of age, period of weaning from breast milk. The diet should be supplemented with the vitamin C. Okay, so we have to give the child the amla or lemon, right? Otherwise, the child will suffer from the scurvy, okay, deficiency. Like vitamin A deficiency, it affects the vision, right? Night blindness, xerophthalmia, keratomalacia, bitter spot. Vitamin D deficiency lead to the rickets in adult and osteomalacia in rickets in children and osteomalacia in adult. Like that, vitamin C deficiency lead to which disease? Remember this. It is asked in many MCQs. Scurvy, remember. So there is a chance of hemorrhagic tendency. So collagen, because collagen for the post-translation modification of lysine and proline, that will help in the collagen stability. So here collagen is abnormal. So intracellular cement substance is brittle and capillary are fragile, leading to the bleeding. Okay, there is a subcutaneous hemorrhage, which are called as petechy and ecchymosis. They are seen in case of the scurvy. There will be chance of internal hemorrhage also. Then there is a bleeding gums. Gums become painful, swollen, spongy, and it may bleed. So there will be delayed in wound healing, failure of osteoblast to form the intracellular substance. Okay, that is osteoid. So an anemia will also occur because there is a bleeding chance is increased. Decreased iron absorption because conversion of Fe plus 3 to Fe plus 2 is not formed. Tetrahydrofolic acid, as we know, it is a very important role in the DNA. So, okay. And accumulation of methemoglobin. So methemoglobin is not promoting hemoglobin. That's why it will lead to the anemia. You can see there is sub Okay, petechian ecchymosis, that is the bleeding gums, you can see here identified. Okay, and hemorrhage, subcutaneous hemorrhage, you can see. These are all the feature of scurvy. Remember, if you examine the patient, if you find this, just give vitamin C, person will cure. Okay. So therapeutic dose, like I have told, like Lim C tablet 500 milligram per day. It is used for treatment of ulcer, trauma, burns. Mega dose of vitamin C 2000 to 5000 milligram per day. There is experimental evidence that in animals, aging process is prevented by mega dose of vitamin C. Okay. And it is very helpful in tuberculosis also. And if a person take higher dose, more than 2000 milligram, may lead to the toxicity. It can cause the iron overload because vitamin C helps in the absorption of iron. So don't take extra amount of vitamin C. You can take 500 milligram per day. Yes, the daily requirement is 75 milligram per day. And as there is a water soluble vitamin C, the toxicity chance are less. But if you take so much amount of vitamin C, then it can be toxic, right? So if I revise again, deficiency manifestation, there is a chance of hemorrhagic condition, okay, subcutaneous hemorrhage, bleeding gums, all will be there. Then there will be anemia. This is asked why there is anemia in vitamin C deficiency. So as FEC plus ferric to ferrous is not formed, that is the one, so defective absorption. Then accumulation of methemoglobin, because methemoglobin is not converted to hemoglobin in vitamin C deficiency. There is decreased tetrahydrofolic acid formation, which is important in hemoglobin formation. Right. And lastly, there is a increased chance of bleeding. So decreased blood loss will lead to the anemia. So these are all lead to the anemia. And Barlow's disease is called infantile scurvy. Right. This is all about the vitamin C. If I go to the revision part, right, again, so chemistry we have seen. In chemistry, it is similar to the carbohydrate. So, thus I'm going to revise again. So, it is chemistry is like ascorbic acid. It is other name is ascorbic acid. It is L ascorbic acid, which is a reduced form, and dehydro ascorbic acid, which is oxidized form. And it is similar to carbohydrate. Structure is similar to carbohydrate because of the N-acyl group. Right? Biosynthesis, it is not synthesized in humans because butyrylectron oxidase enzyme is deficient. It is absorbed with the facilitated active transport and with the simple diffusion. And at the blood, it requires a facilitated diffusion. Daily dietary sources, we have seen amla, orange, lemon, they are good source. Requirement daily is 75 milligram per day. Biochemical function, we have seen many functions like in the tryptophan metabolism, tyrosine metabolism, catecholamine synthesis, bile acid synthesis, tetrahydrofolic acid synthesis, conversion of methemoglobin to hemoglobin, conversion of ferric to ferrous form. The main important is in the post-transcriptional modification of proline and lysine residue, and by that in the collagen synthesis. It is the oxidation reduction property, it is act as an antioxidant, it will have a role in the immune system, it will decrease the cataract. So many functions of vitamin C, right, in the carnitine formation like that. Deficiency, many patients, it will lead to the scurvy. Remember this. And therapeutic dose, it can be used in the tuberculosis megadose in the experimental animal has shown that it can reduce the aging. So always take vitamin C in your diet. Many times in our diet, we don't take vitamin C. So always remember, it is a water-soluble vitamin. It has to be given regularly. So always see that you get good amount of vitamin C in your diet. And if person take high dose of vitamin C, more than 200 milligram, it can lead to the iron overload. So this is all about the vitamin C. I hope you like this video. This will be helpful to you. If it is helpful to you, please share this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can watch the notification for my future video also. So thanks, friends, for students, for watching. Thank you. Bye.